This is a model of CYP51, a protein found in the pathogen that causes the fungal disease barley powdery mildew. What makes this particular fungal protein very significant is that if a strain of barley powdery mildew is to become resistant to a fungicide, it most likely will be because of a mutation in this gene.
Fungicides that used to be successful at controlling barley powdery mildew, particularly tebuconazole and triademinol, are now failing to control those fungicides. And that's the phenotypic side of things. That's actually what the fungus growing on the plant and us observing what's going on. The other side of the coin, and this is where we're using research from overseas very intensively, is that we know that resistance to these fungicides, these DMI class of fungicides, is almost always due to changes in the gene sequence of a gene called CYP51 or CYP51.
The failure of fungicides to control powdery mildew in Western Australian barley has resulted in a massive build-up of pathogen. Any strains within that population that have developed fungicide resistance have an even better opportunity to further multiply and mutate. A mutation results in an approximate tenfold increase in resistance. What has compounded the problem is the sowing of susceptible barley varieties.
The best barley variety in WA in terms of quality is very, very susceptible to powdery mildew. Traditionally, we've been able to control powdery mildew with quite cheap triazoles, and this form of fungicide is now broken down completely in WA. And because you have a susceptible variety that you can continually have to spray, that opened up the opportunity for resistance.
Professor Oliver's team has been taking isolates from field samples of the fungus and exposing them to the various fungicides at different concentrations. Resistant isolates have their DNA sequenced and cross-checked against mutations known to have resistance to the DMI, also known as the triazole, group of fungicides.
The issue, though, is that this stepwise process of mutation that we see happening, or we have seen happening in Europe. So if we have resistance to mutations, resistance to fungicides like tebuconazole, which take just one or two mutations, that's the stepping stone to getting resistance to these newer fungicides like prothioconazole, prozaro, and epoxiconazole, opus. Well, that might occur when we accumulate together a whole batch of mutations in the gene. And this scenario might happen if we continue to allow a very large population of the fungus to grow on susceptible plants and give those already mutant population a chance to mutate a second, third and fourth time, which is really the nightmare scenario.
Modelling the CYP51 protein and its mutations allows the team to see which fungicides fit with the protein's substrate binding pocket, like a key in a lock.
Therefore, we can say a particular mutation or set of mutations on the gene are associated with resistance, say, to tebuconazole, but sensitivity to, say, epoxiconazole. And that's very sophisticated work that we're using by collaborating with our European colleagues.
Identification of mutants and establishing if they are sensitive or resistant to fungicides will also provide barley breeders with valuable genetic data.
In our terms, we say which avirulence genes have they got or which they haven't they got. So which race are they? On that basis, we can then say to the breeders, it's a waste of time using this resistance gene, but this resistance gene is still working. And therefore, we can say to growers, use this cultivar, which is resistant, and not that cultivar, which has fallen over. So if growers adopt resistant cultivars, we'll have much, much less of the pathogen around. Therefore, there will be much less opportunity for it to mutate and for those mutated strains to then be selected by the fungicides.
What will help growers to reduce further losses to barley powdery mildew in the short term is to sow newer, less susceptible varieties next season and be more selective of the fungicides they use. And if any grower nationwide has powdery mildew in their barley crop, especially if they're growing newer varieties, contact Richard Oliver, who will arrange for a sample to be tested.
Most of the barley varieties in the east are more resistant than we've been using in the west, so they're starting from a better position than we are. But certainly we are worried about this on a national scale. Powdery mildew is a pathogen that doesn't respect state boundaries. It blows around hundreds of kilometres in a few days, so it should be no problem to get from west to east. We're also interested to hear from growers if they had failures of some of the newer fungicides, such as Opus, Opera, Amistar and so on, Prozaro. Because if they are failing, then we need to replace those with the yet newer fungicides and bring forward our program for introducing the new, which you might call the third class of fungicides.
Providing barley breeders and growers with options is within reach, and the barley industry should take confidence from knowing GRDC will continue to support this research, according to its Western Region Chairman, Peter Roberts.
We have to continue to evolve this investment to make sure that we have options available for control. And the other angle is to breed the resistance into the cultivar, but that's been quite difficult, and Richard works in that area as well.
We've got all the tools available to control it. We just need to implement them, and then we'll be on top of this pathogen in a few years, I hope.